Here with Steve Ryder, coach of Gold Coast Knights. Again, another 3-2 loss, second week in a row, but another good performance up until the red card. Went ahead early. How do you see it from your end?
Look, I was very confident coming into this game, and we knew all we needed 3 points, and you know, we knew that we can roll them today, and it was looking good up to 80th minute. It was 2-2, and then unfortunately the red card almost ruined a good game, I thought. And but saying that, you know, with our poor discipline record, you know, you can't go through a season like that. So it's one of those things.
Well, I thought you deservedly went ahead, and then after that, Broadbeach came back into it, couldn't hold them off until half time. What did you say at half time to the boys?
Look, we changed the formation slightly because we were getting overrun in the middle of the park, and Broadie seemed to play some good counter football. And they're dangerous going right through the middle of the channels. So we changed our formation. It seemed to work in the second half. And I was very confident getting the 3 points today, if we had all 11 points in the park.
Yeah, a little bit of ill discipline sometimes can ruin it. Yes. Unfortunate, you'll have them both out for next week.
Look, you know, I know you're thinking Southport next week. I mean, we almost lost to Southport last time, you know. I mean, we do struggle with the... with everyone at the moment. But, you know, I fear Southport. I mean, they've got nothing to play for but pride. So they're going to come out and they're going to play 100%. So, you know, it's a tough week this week of training, and hopefully the boys can pull it through.
All right, well, thank you for talking to us. Good luck for next week. Unlucky today.
Cool. Thanks, Dan.
Here with Matt Silcock, coach of Broadbeach. Made to work hard for that victory, especially with a lot of players out. In the end, too good, too strong, too good with the attacking players you had. How do you see it from the sideline?
Yeah, pretty much, like I said, we had a lot of players in the house. You know, quite scrapped the game. They played very direct. We and caught it out for the first 25 minutes. We then went to a very short passing game. Tried to switch the ball a lot quicker. Got the goals from that. Again, they still continue to be a danger, knocking ball into box and looking for second balls off their strikers. They got their rewards playing that way, but you know, the best football inside today got the result, and we're happy with 3-2.
Yeah, you went behind early, which seems to be happening a bit lately. Showed good character though to get back into it and keep creating chances, and eventually it took them. And then in the end, once the red card, you capitalised on that and then just held on for the victory.
Yeah, we talked very heavily about having players having a good ticker. We've shown a heart and a courage for the club. And we've had to do that a few times. We've been down 2-1 against Burley at their place. We had to show a bit of ticker and come back and win 3-2. I thought Justin in the middle of the park had one of his best performances this year. Really bossed that midfield, not just showing his passing creativity, but also a bit of a physical side to the game, which is probably not over the last couple of games. But the players deserve all the credit and take all the plaudits for the fight that they put in today. So, well done to the players.
Well, it's good for Norrie to get another game under his belt, looking ever more dangerous now that he's come back into the side.
Yeah, Norrie's a danger. Norrie's a danger all the time. You know, he causes teams completely different defense problems than any of our other strikers give them. Every time you get 90 minutes in the nose belt, you know it's building up to something good, and he'll be on form provided we make the playoffs and if we can make the final.
Well, congratulations on the 3 points. See you next week.
Yeah, no, cheers. Look after yourself.
That's right.